हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम एनके जैन फ्रॉम स्किल ऑन टेक। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप्स ओवरलोड ट्रिप्स। व्हाई सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप्स ओवरलोड? पंप्स ओवरलोडिंग अकर्स इन सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप्स व्हेन द ड्राइविंग मोटर ड्रॉज एक्सेस करंट रिजल्टिंग इन एक्सेस देन नॉर्मल रेटेड पावर कंजप्शन। This overloading of the pumps can be caused by various reasons that will be discussed in the next slides. Requirement of hydraulic power for operating a pump can be calculated using the following equation: power kilowatt equal to Q into H into S upon 3.6 into 10 to the power 6, where Q is a flow rate in meter cube per hour, H is head in meters of fluid, S is specific gravity of the liquid which is handled by the pump. Major reasons for pump overloading. Total head of system either higher or lower than anticipated. Pump operating too far out on head capacity curve. Imbalance in rotating components. Misalignment between pump and driver. Excess gland packings. If pump stuffing box is filled with excessive gland packings, that will also produce more friction and will be a very important reason for drawing more current from motor. Bent shaft. Oversized impeller installed. Speed too high. Worn or damaged bearings. Process liquid of higher viscosity. Rotating parts in contact with stationary parts. Mechanical seal exert excessive pressure on seat. Here in these two curves you can see, in an axial flow pump, this is a capacity on x-axis and this is a head on y-axis and this is a curve. So power will be drawn more initially in axial flow pumps and then it drastically power will come down. But in case of radial flow pumps, your power goes like this. If your pump is running on HQ curve, at BP, then it will take minimum power. But if it is running, pump is running out of BEP, best efficiency point, then pump will take more current and that will be a condition of overloading, which you can see here. Defective bearings. You can see a picture of defecting bearings. Overload in pump may occur if bearing are worn out, causes pump to draw excess current. Bearing problems are duplicate bearings, bad installation of bearings, defective lubrication or greasing, high temperature. So, how to correct bearing problem? Replace the bearing and make a root cause analysis. Use appropriate bearing as per load and lubricants. Review bearing mounting practices. If bearing mounting practices are not correct, then they shall be reviewed and correct practices shall be adopted. Check if the operating conditions are suitable for the bearing. So, operating condition of bearing shall be proper and bearing temperature shall not exceed high. There shall be a proper lubrication in the bearings. Misalignment. If your pump and motor are not properly aligned, that will also be a very important reason to draw more current by motor and it will also increase vibrations. You can see a picture where a mechanic or a technician is carrying out alignment of pump with motor. When a misalignment is detected in a centrifugal pump, so what we have to do? Verify the alignment procedure used and the standards applied. Verify if there is a soft foot, both of pumps and the motor. Provide alignment tolerance for thermal expansion. skilled technicians to carry out alignment. Alignment is a one very important part while we are coupling pump with motor. So skilled technicians only to be given this critical work. Other than this, the alignment methods also to be taken care. Nowadays in latest technology, laser alignment tools are available and they are very good, and most of the industries nowadays use laser alignment practices. Bent pump shaft. You can see a picture of a pump shaft which is bent. A bent shaft will cause of drawing more current due to imbalance operations and excess friction in rotating components. A pump with a bent shaft can cause high axial vibration with axial phase differences that tends towards 180 degree on the same rotor. A dominant vibration normally takes place at 1:2 RPM if the bend is near the shaft center. It can occur at 2:2 RPM if it is bent near the coupling. So, if your distance of the bend will increase from the center of the shaft, then your vibrations will also increase. Bent pump shaft are more likely to happen at or near the coupling. So generally it is observed that shafts are bent near the coupling. So this should be properly inspected while we are assembling pump, that shaft is perfectly okay and its runout has been checked properly. Imbalance and rotating parts in contact with stationary parts. You can see a picture of a worn out impeller of pump. Pump impellers, centrifugal pump impellers, generally balanced as per standard ISO 1940 in grade 6.3. If your pump impeller is not perfectly balanced, then due to unbalance, it can causing touching with the impeller bearing rings, casing bearing rings, so that will increase friction. So therefore, pump impeller shall be balanced as per standards and in specified grade. Non-uniform impeller wear. If your impeller is wear out, non-uniform, for example by cavitation or blade breakage, you can see a picture of an impeller which is worn out by cavitation. Rotating component clearances shall be maintained as per standard procedure. So, casing bearing ring or impeller bearing ring or other rotating component clearances shall be maintained as per pump assembly standard procedure or as per the guidance of original equipment manufacturer. Bent shaft may increase friction between shaft and bearings. If your shaft is bent, then certainly the friction between bearing and shaft will increase and will cause to drawing more current by motor. Worn out impeller may cause touching casing ring and cause increased friction. Mechanical seal exert excessive pressure on seat and excess gland packings. You can see a centrifugal pump where a gland leakage is coming, or you can say a mechanical seal is leaking. Mechanical seal exert excessive pressure due to overheating of seals when operating the pump without sealant. High vibrations due to misalignment or imbalance, bad mounting of mechanical seal, and bad seal selection. If your seal is also not proper, then that will also cause for exerting excessive friction. When seal problems are detected in pump, what we have to do? Check the condition of the alignment and balancing of the pump. Check if the operating conditions are suitable for the mechanical seal. Review mechanical seal installation practices. So, installation of a mechanical seal is a very important, and a skilled technician can do this job. So, if there is any problem in seal installation, that then procedure should be reviewed and a proper practice of seal installation shall be adopted. Prevent the pump from running dry. Gland packing in a stuffing box shall be appropriate. We have seen if excess gland packings are provided in the pump, sometimes it does not get started and it immediately trip on overload. So suitable and a proper size of gland packings shall be provided in a stuffing box. So we should not overload the pump by fixing more gland packings in the stuffing box. Oversize impeller and speed too high. The size of impeller and speed of a pump is very important in calculating power drawn by motor. So with shaft speed n held constant and for small variations in impeller diameter by trimming, we can see the relations Q1 by Q2 equal to D1 by D2. Means Q is proportional to D, diameter of the impeller. So if diameter of the impeller will increase, your flow of the pump will increase. The pump developed head, the total dynamic head H, varies to the square of the trimmed impeller diameter. So what is the relation? H1 by H2 equal to D1 by D2 square. The power varies to the cube of the trimmed impeller diameter. P1 upon P2 equal to D1 upon D2 cube. So power will increase in cubes if diameter of the impeller is increased. Therefore, the impeller size is very important in deciding the what current will be drawn by motor because of flow and head. So you can see a graph here where it is shown, this is a pressure, flow and power. If we'll increase the diameter of a impeller, your power drawn will be more by the pump. Therefore, as per the requirement of the flow and head, impeller dia should be decided. If it is a oversized impeller and if your pump is tipping on overload and your requirement is less for flow and head, then we have to trim the impeller and then we have to assemble the impeller in the pump. Pump operating too far from BEP. Centrifugal pump operation to the right of the BEP, best efficiency point, has different set of problems. Edge cavitation may occur, shaft may undergo deflection, mechanical seals and bearings can be stressed. This can cause a drop in pump efficiency and an increase in power consumption by pump, which may cause the motor to trip on overload. So here you can see in this picture that this is our HQ curve and this is our efficiency curve. And this is our power curve. So you can see this is the best efficiency point because HQ curve is meeting here at this efficiency, best efficiency point. If pump will run this side on this HQ curve, then you can see here power is increasing. So power drawn by motor will be more if pump will be run on this point or this point. Minimum power will be drawn at the best efficiency point here because it will meet here. So if pump is operating too far from BEP, then it will be a major reason for drawing more current by motor and pump can trip on overload. So this should be taken care while operating the centrifugal pumps. NPSH, net positive suction head, pump cavitation. As we know, all centrifugal pumps are required a minimum NPSH. So one is a required NPSH, other one is a available NPSH. So available NPSH should be always more than the required NPSH of the pump. Otherwise, cavitation in the pump may occur. So pump cavitation is a symptom of insufficient net positive suction head. It occurs when the absolute pressure of the liquid at the impeller inlet approaches the liquid vapor pressure, causing pockets to form and collapse as they pass through the impeller. If NPSH will be less than the required NPSH, the fluid which is handled will vaporize and form bubbles. So when pump is under operation, that bubbles will go with the discharge fluid towards the discharge side of the impeller face, and there, due to high pressure, they will be collapsed. And due to collapsing of the bubbles, a vacuum will be created and the high pressure fluid will impact on the impeller face, and that will damage the impeller. So you can see a picture of a damage of impeller by cavitation in this slide. For your reference, the impeller has been destroyed because of cavitation, because cavitation occurs and a hammering sound you can observe in the pump when cavitation will occur in the pump. Cavitation identified by the sound of the pump beyond excess noise, higher energy uses and damage to the pump may be observed. Hot water handling pumps may be taken care to meet NPSH requirement, because due to hot water, when we are handling hot water or condensate by a pump, then that NPSH will be very important criteria to be looked into, because due to temperature, your NPSH required will be increases. Process liquid of higher viscosity. You can see a graph of head power efficiency versus flow rate. As we know, all the centrifugal pumps are designed for handling water as a standard fluid. If we are handling fluid other than water, then viscosity of fluid will impact on power drawn by a pump. If we handle more viscous fluids than water, it will increase friction in the system. When a more viscous fluid is handled by a centrifugal pump, brake horsepower requirement increases, the head generated is reduced and capacity is reduced. So head and capacity of the pump will reduce if viscosity of fluid is more. So this will adversely impact on efficiency of the pump, and efficiency of pump is reduced, and best efficiency point BEP it's shifted. Generally, all these features of handling different kind of viscosity fluids has been taken care by the pump manufacturers. But this is also one reason which may be cause for overloading of the pump. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.